Well, hello everyone, and welcome to today's Terry Talks Nutrition Educational Webinar Series. Today we are very excited to be having Dr. Holly Lucille talking with us today about Andrographis, and one of its names you may know it as is the King of Bitters. Now, Dr. Holly Lucille is a nationally recognized licensed naturopathic doctor. She is also an integrative medical expert, educator, natural products consultant, and patient advocate. She is the author of several books, including Creating and Maintaining Balance, A Women's Guide to Safe, Natural Hormone Health. And Dr. Holly has numerous media appearances on outlets like Dr. Oz, The Doctors, Lifetime Television for Women, PBS's Healing Quest, The Hallmark Channel, and Discovery Fit and Health Channel. So thank you so much, Dr. Holly Lucille, for joining us today, and I'm going to go ahead and turn things over to you.
All right. Well, screw all of those media outlets, because I just am so excited to be right here, because this is one of my favorite plants ever. I was so excited to be asked to talk about Andrographis because, you know, as a patient advocate, what that really means to me is, how can I help you, the people out there? You know, I have this education and what have you, and you can come and see me in my practice, but how can you be your best self? How can you get closer to your healthcare desires and goals? And when you're looking at plant medicine or botanical medicine, there's plenty of things that we can talk about. I mean, there's curcumin. You've heard me talk about that before. But Andrographis, as far as how medicinal it is, I think it's just so important for every single person in this world to know about. So I'm so happy to be right here. So we'll dive in. Historically, this plant has been used. It comes from Asian countries like India and Sri Lanka, and it's, like I said, highly medicinal. Wide variety of uses, and mostly sort of a system of medicine called Ayurvedic medicine since ancient times. It's also known as an Indian echinacea. And, you know, it's funny because most folks think that when we talk about echinacea here, we're thinking about only immune system. But if you get into really the broad spectrum of medicinal components of echinacea, it goes well beyond. And you'll see this with Andrographis as well. So it's also used in traditional Chinese medicine for over 1,000 years, and it's commonly referred to, as Lexi said, as the King of Bitters. And that's just a particular subset of botanical medicine. Bitters are basically plants that you would take maybe before a meal or so to help stimulate the digestive system. So from a historical perspective, we've got traditional uses that span anywhere from GI issues all the way over to ear and skin infections, including fever and hepatitis and stomach ulcers and respiratory issues. And soon here, as we move on through this presentation, you're going to understand why. So currently, we can use this, and you can get this off the shelf, and you can have this in your house and take it every single day. I know, because I do, and I have most of my patients on it. It strengthens the immune system. It stops viruses and resistant bacteria. It soothes digestive disorders. It protects the heart and arteries. It prevents pain and inflammation and arthritis and other symptoms that are related to those things. It prevents tumors and cell damage. And it also protects the liver, our big liver that does 500 different functions, and it is our main detoxification organ. And so you're like, how in the heck can this one particular plant do all of this? Well, the thing that I love most about botanical medicine or plant medicine is that there are so many different components of the plant that have medicinal qualities that can touch molecular targets in the body, and this is how we get to have these many different effects in the body. So that one of its well-known uses in the United States is that it helps prevent the common cold and reduce the intensity of symptoms, especially when we're talking about sore throat, runny nose, so this upper respiratory tract infection, right? There was actually a study in that Andrographis relieved the intensity of key symptoms, things like fatigue, runny nose, sleeplessness, fatigue, sore throat, in just 2 days. And what is most important? Here is what I always say when it comes to the common cold or the flu virus. If you get it, you know you got it, all right? There's really nothing that you can do. You got it. But can you decrease the intensity of the symptoms, and can you delay the duration that that virus is going to take hold? And yes, you can, and this is definitely one of the ways that you can do that with Andrographis. By the fourth day in this particular study, there was a significant decrease in all symptoms, including other ones such as headache, earache, phlegm production, and the frequency and intensity of coughing attacks. And of course, when a cough is involved, usually that increases the sleeplessness, and your day starts the night before. So if we can get on top of all of this for definitely prevention, but at first sign. So if you have this on hand and you have it in your cold and flu first aid kit at first sign, and everybody has like a different first sign when it comes to cold and flu, right? So you could, some people, like mine is a little scratchy throat. Some people get sniffles. Some, their eyes start to tear up. But whatever it is for you, at first sign, this is going to help. So it strengthens the immune system. Really important. So also, for an upper respiratory tract infection, there was a randomized study including 223 patients who received either a placebo or Andrographis. And the results were about the same for the first few days. However, the third day, the Andrographis group experienced a dramatic decrease in cough, headache, sore throat, and as well, that disturbed sleep, which when you sleep, guess what you do? You heal. That's what's most important. And so the placebo group experienced no improvement or actually had their symptoms even get worse. So that's the point that I want to drive home once again is at first sign. That first 2 days, yeah, you're sick. You know, you got to take maybe a day off of work. You should definitely rest. Fatigue is the immune system's secondary response to infection because your immune system does work best when you're at rest. But now you've got something that you can take right away, and you know you can decrease duration and also the intensity of your symptoms. So another thing that this has been proven to help with is those embarrassing and painful cold sores. So this is caused by the herpes simplex virus. We know that. And researchers in Thailand actually found that a compound, once again, these medicinal different compounds in these plants, so this compound in Andrographis, inhibited the virus 12 hours after infection, okay? And it also found to work well with acyclovir, which is a very common drug given for cold sores or shingles, that particular family of viruses. And so think about it there, too. If you have a history, once again, you've got a virus. Usually we have viruses and we can keep them in remission and dormant, or if our immune system gets compromised, they're going to kind of rear their ugly heads in a sense. And so this is something that you could have on board that you could take with the acyclovir and maybe even decrease the dosage of acyclovir because this is working concomitantly alongside to decrease these cold sores and to get this virus under control. And once again, also supporting the immune system. So another use in our day with Andrographis is antibacterial. So in addition to its antiviral properties that we talked about, it can also stop the growth of harmful bacteria, including Staph aureus. Staph aureus is basically a gram-positive bacteria that's often found on the skin or in that upper respiratory tract that can cause those upper respiratory tract infections. And research shows that it prevents the bacteria from enlisting its own antioxidant defenses necessary for replication. That's pretty impressive. And it also boosts the body's own natural antibacterial and antiviral defenses. So you've got sort of a double whammy happening here. You not only have antibacterial activity happening from the plant, you've got your own body's immune system being enhanced, your T cells, natural killer cells, phagocytes, those things that come to play when the body needs to fight an oncoming infection. So not only does it suppress the offending organism, it also increases the body's ability to do its job, which is to heal and fight off these incoming viruses and bacteria. So just another shout out for this Andrographis that we are loving so much. So some really compelling research when it comes to cancer and Andrographis. It's been shown in scientific studies to, now this was particularly melanoma, to stop the cycle of cancer cell growth. The American Cancer Association predicts that over 90,000 Americans will be diagnosed with melanoma in 2018 alone. 90,000 folks. So stops the cycle of cancer cell growth. And you can see the citations below. Those are really important because these aren't just things that we say or that I say. These are things that we know through clinical studies. It also stopped the growth of formation of pancreatic tumor cells and suppressed the ability of glioblastoma multiform cells to migrate. And that is a really aggressive brain tumor. It's the brain tumor that I see him in my mind and I can't think of his name, but I will and I'll come back and say it. And you all I know are thinking about it right now. One of the governors just died in Arizona. But very, very aggressive. And so suppress the ability of that glioblastoma multiform cells to migrate, which is extremely important. So also liver protection, as I had sort of mentioned before. Research actually shows that a compound from Andrographis called andrographolide can be as effective as milk thistle. Now, milk thistle is extremely effective. It is hepatoprotective. It means it can protect those liver cells from all the damage out there from either medication use, excuse me, or alcohol use, or the many different toxins that we can come into contact with. So it decreases liver, it helps to decrease the liver damage from these toxins. And that's extremely important because the liver is, yes, a very resilient organ, but it goes through a lot, and it needs as much protection in these modern days as we can offer it. And so extremely important there. It also has been shown to stop the overproliferation of cells that can lead to cirrhosis. When cells in the liver get to be cirrhotic, they basically stop working. And this can happen at this point in time, we all know of alcoholic cirrhosis of the liver, but there's also a non-alcoholic fatty liver or cirrhosis that happens from too much sugar, believe it or not, and it's showing up in children. So extremely important there. The other thing that I want to mention from a liver perspective is that the extracts of Andrographis have been shown to boost not only glutathione, but also superoxide dismutase. Both of those very powerful antioxidants, superoxide dismutase, or otherwise known as SOD, helps to reduce cellular damage. And so extremely important in increasing our own antioxidants and protecting the liver. John McCain. Okay, I just remembered John McCain's name. And yes, he is the gentleman that died from the aggressive brain tumor. And I've had two friends in this past year also pass away, believe it or not, and so we're looking at compelling research to help stop that. So thank you and for your patience on me and my recall. I just get so excited, I think, about Andrographis that that's pretty much all I can think about. So moving on from the liver to GI issues, look at this, and once again, well cited. We've got ulcerative colitis. Andrographolide was found to inhibit interleukin 23 and interleukin 17, this axis, which creates many downstream inflammatory compounds. So when you think about itis, and ulcerative colitis is a condition in your colon, so colitis, inflammation. So we're looking at inhibiting this downstream inflammation. Gastric ulcer prevention, so pretreatment with Andrographis increased the pH balance, boosted gastric mucus production, which is extremely important, and reduced the risk of stomach lining lesions. Do you know that your stomach acid, which we need so much, okay? We need stomach acid. We don't want to suppress stomach acid. Stomach acid is important for absorption of trace minerals. It is important to break down proteins. But it's so strong that if you had a drop of it, it would burn a hole right through your hand. And the way that it doesn't burn a hole right through our stomach is because we have this thing called mucin. And so this helps, increase the pH balance. It boosts this gastric mucus production so we can help protect and then also then prevent gastric ulcers. And then in a separate study, Andrographis was shown to preserve mucin, as I was just talking about. This is a protein that helps create that mucosal lining in duodenum and stabilize the balance of healthy glutathione. That glutathione production, once again, very important point. And I have to tell you this point, if folks don't know this. You know, when we saw that big picture of the liver a couple slides ago, you've got like bazillion hepatocytes or liver cells. When we're looking at the intestines, believe it or not, that hole that starts at your mouth and ends all the way back there, guess what? It is one cell thick. One cell thick. So that's why increasing gastric mucosal production, increasing mucin is so important to continue to have good integrity of that mucosal lining. It's only one cell thick. We've got to protect it. I know it's kind of amazing, but we're going on to something else, liver, GI, and now joint support. So research now shows that Andrographis stops inflammatory triggers that can cause an overexpression of something called matrix metalloproteinase, otherwise known as MMPs. And they're little components that can destroy the cartilage between the joints. My dad is 80 years old, and I wish I would have had him on this many, many years ago, because right now, because of his inflammation and because of his arthritis, he is basically bone on bone on both shoulders. And I know that his MMPs were out of control, and he has destroyed all cartilage. And so this would have been extremely helpful. So also, andrographolide has a direct action on an inflammatory enzyme called COX-2. And in a placebo-controlled clinical study on patients with rheumatoid arthritis, which I see, unfortunately, more and more every day in my practice, Andrographis reduced joint swelling and tenderness and reduced the inflammatory factors associated with rheumatoid arthritis. Symptom control with folks who have an autoimmune disease like rheumatoid arthritis is extremely important. And I know with taking Andrographis, they're getting way more than symptom relief. They're actually getting support with antioxidant production, their immune system support, and as well that decrease in inflammation, which makes a big deal always round. I know, moving on, we're going to joint, now to heart and arteries. But the research is there, and this is why I'm so excited to be talking about this particular plant, because it has many applications, and it's almost like one of those, I would say, desert island supplements. It's like if you're going on a deserted island and that's, you can take maybe one or two things or three, this is definitely going to be in my backpack for sure. So reduces the peroxidation of lipids for cholesterol balance. One of the things that I always like to educate with my patients is that there's really no bad cholesterol out there. I know that's a big slang term for, you know, good and bad cholesterol, and, you know, HDL is good and LDL is bad. There's no real good or bad. It's like everything else. There needs to be a balance in the ratios. And also those low-density lipoproteins, those LDLs, if they are oxidized, they become, they kind of puff up, right? If they're, you know, they're peroxidation, so they get oxidized, they puff up. And when they puff up and get big, what happens is they nick the artery. And your body, because it's meant to heal itself, right, goes, there's a little cut there. Let's send out the immune system or platelets. So platelets go over and, like, let's fix this. But that's where plaque starts to be laid down. And so this is something that can help that. It can decrease platelet aggregation that can cause that artery blockage. In a clinical trial, actually, Andrographis extract was just as effective as a drug used to treat elevated triglycerides. So triglycerides, you're thinking of three, right? Glycerol is sugar. So you've got three sugar molecules on a fatty acid backbone. Elevated triglycerides, sure, you can take a medication for them, but it's pretty modifiable with diet, because we're thinking about sugar and fat, mostly sugar there. But in a clinical study, Andrographis is just as effective as a medication on the market for high triglycerides. It also has a vasodilating effect. very, very useful for people with hypertension. And then when we're talking about heart and arteries, it has shown to reduce the damage to the heart and blood vessels within an hour after a myocardial infarction. This is just my plea, once again, for folks to have this on hand no matter what. So at first sign, all right, with colds and flu, and then God forbid if you happen to have a myocardial infarction, we get to do that healing as soon as possible. Heart disease continues to be the number one killer of both men and women in the United States, and we can heal and thrive after the heart has been damaged, but this is definitely something at first sign that will continue to help. So I know that was a lot, but this is such an important topic for me because it does do a lot, and I know probably some of you are scratching your head like, how can that be? But once again, when we're talking about, you know, if you've seen Terry talk nutrition and we talked about curcumin or grapeseed extract or those things, you know, it's because of the miracle of plant medicine, and that a lot of times when we're talking about medications or pharmaceuticals, and you all who have heard me talk before, you know, my parents are both pharmacists. My mom passed away 4 years ago, so my dad's still a pharmacist, and, you know, there's a lot of value, I think, you know, in any system of medicine, and certainly pharmaceutical medication saves lives. But usually there's one mechanism of action that they have, right? So like a COX-2 inhibitor, like Celebrex that used to be on the market, it does one thing. It inhibits that COX-2 inflammatory enzyme, right, that cascade. When we're looking at plant medicine, the reason that I can sit here and get so excited and go through things like immune health and liver health and joint and heart and arteries is because plant medicine is so brilliant in the fact that when we're using a whole plant or using the components that have been isolated as medicinal, then we see that there's different molecular targets in the body that can be hit, and that's why there are so many different effects, all right? So this is an adaptogenic herb. So it helps adapt your body adapt to what it basically needs. So it works in the body to restore balance. It has that downstream benefit for a wide variety of physiological symptoms, including, like I said, and not limited to, the immune system, inflammatory response, organ system from digestive to liver to heart. It's been proven historically in both Ayurvedic and traditional Chinese medicine, and it's on the cutting-edge research, currently over 800 studies in the National Institute of Health PubMed database. All you have to do is go into PubMed and put this in, and these all populate and pop up because it's there. The research is there, but also from a clinical perspective, I see it in my practice all the time. And like I said, it's a deserted island supplement for me. That is for sure. So here's what you want to look for when you're thinking about a supplement. So Andrographis that contains both. And this is important. Why? Because I was talking about whole plant medicine. Both the stem and leaf extracts to optimize the variety of compounds that are found in the blend, okay? Sort of like the entourage effect, the synergy. You know, as with many other valuable botanicals that we've talked about, the main compounds are more powerful when supported by the other phytonutrients found in the leaf and the stem. You know, so the entourage, you know, that the show Entourage, you know, you got your main guy, right? But he's got his buddies behind him. It's like, I got your back. I got my posse of peeps, or however you say it, right? This is exactly what it is with plant medicine. It's that synergy effect. It's the entourage effect. Scientifically studied, ask the company, where can I see, you know, this particular extract in the studies, and a dosage of at least 80 milligrams per day of andrographolide without the bitterness, okay? So I didn't want you to be scared about the king of bitters, because bitters definitely, you know, we can say bitter taste is like, some people don't like that, or a bitter person. I know most people don't like that. But with this, you don't have to have the bitterness. And as well with many, many plant medicines, I should say all plant medicines, the dosage is really important. I can't tell you how many times I have somebody come in my office and they've got something and they've read about it and they bring it in and I look at it and it's a fraction of the dose that I know is going to make a body claim. It makes a label claim because they see it there, they've read about it, it's on the label, but did it make any effect whatsoever in the body? At that dose, I can say confidently no. So look for both the stem and the leaf extracts, make sure scientifically studied, and that you've got at least 80 milligrams per day of that component of andrographolide, that main medicinal component. I know this is short but sweet, but I wanted everybody to know about andrographolide, and I thank you for your time.
Thank you so much for joining us today, Dr. Holly Lucille. This has been absolutely enlightening on andrographis. I know it is not a very common botanical for many people, but it's starting to really pick up steam. So we are so grateful for you sharing your knowledge and your passion on this topic. And if you do have any questions on andrographis, you can always send them via the Terry Talks Nutrition website. If you would like additional information, you can also sign up for a free weekly newsletter at terrytalksnutrition.com. And as Dr. Holly mentioned, we have a lot of archived webinars on a variety of different topics, from andrographis to boswellia to curcumin, just about the whole ABCs of natural medicine. So if any of those interest you, feel free to go to YouTube, where all of our webinars live, and you can find them at youtube.com/TerryTalksNutrition. So thank you so much, everyone, for joining us today to learn more about andrographis, and we will talk to you soon. Good health to you. Bye-bye.